Hello, welcome to a new episode. Today's topic is Linear Regression Part 4, Residuals and Leverages. Today we'll focus our attention on the residuals and the leverages. With the residuals, we can identify the unusual values in the dependent variable y. With the leverages, we can identify the unusual values in the independent variable x. The objective is to identify the data values that have the most influence on the regression analysis. Please watch the previous episodes if you haven't done so already. They are helpful in understanding today's video. A residual is a deviation of the actual measurement from the model estimation. For example, suppose that we model the data with a straight line. The deviation of the measured y value from this line would be the residual. This way, it is easy to detect the unusual values in the y variable by inspecting the residuals. Formally, the residual of an observation is the measured y minus the estimated y, which is denoted as y hat. Similarly, we can also define the standardized residual using the following expression. Here, e sub I is the residual just defined above. H sub II are the diagonal elements of the H matrix as defined by this expression. Now, the leverage can tell you about how far an x value is from the center. This way, it is easy to detect the unusual values in the x variable by inspecting the leverage. As in these figures, a large leverage means more impact. The impact we are talking about is on the regression parameters. Formally, the leverage of an observation is given by a diagonal element of the H matrix that we saw a few slides ago. What is interesting is that there is a so-called sum rule, which says that the sum of all the leverages must be equal to the number of the parameters denoted here by the letter P. So, how can we tell whether the leverage is high or low? From the sum rule of the previous slide, we can say that the average value of the leverage is the number of the parameters divided by the number of observations. Above this average would be high leverage, and below it would be low leverage. Now, there's the so-called Cook's distance. It is given by the following expression. Cook's distance measures the influence of each observation. We could say that it sort of combines the concepts of the leverage and the residual. For this example, we have a simulated data set. The x variable goes from minus 5 to 5, and the y variable has some statistical noise built in. And the relationship between x and y seems to be roughly linear. We go to the PremExcel tab, select Linear, and then Forecast. For the training data, we select the cell ranges for x and y. For the testing data, we select the same x range as for the training. Now we specify the output location. Finally, we press the run button to execute. The result is the estimation of the variable y by the linear model. Here in the plot, the estimation is shown as a blue straight line. We go back to the PremExcel tab, select Linear, and then Fit. We select the cell ranges for X and Y. And then we specify the output location. Now, your attention please. We deselect these two boxes and select these two that allow for the output of the residuals and the leverages. Finally, we press the run button to execute. We can notice new sheets which are named leverage and residuals. Let's go to the residuals sheet. Here we have the residuals and the standardized residuals. Back to the data sheet, let us change our Y value to something else. We can notice that the corresponding residual has increased. When the standardized residual is beyond the range of minus 2 and 2, we could say that we have an outlier in the Y value. Let's move to the sheet named leverage. We can notice that the leverage gets larger as we move away from the center of X. Also, we can see the cook's distance. Back to the data sheet, let us change the X value at a high leverage position. So this position has even higher leverage. Then we also change the Y value. These changes would cause a very large influence on the regression result. We can notice that the estimation line is now completely off from the general trend. We can verify that both the leverage and the cook's distance have become quite large at this particular position. In real life, when we have this kind of situation, we should be very cautious and should make sure that the values at the high leverage positions are real and not the illusion of the statistical noise. Now, back to the data sheet, let us move a data point at the low leverage position. This time, only vertically or in the Y direction. Well, the estimation line does move, but the change is not as drastic as before. The cook's distance has increased, but the leverage remains the same. So, a change at the low leverage position has more subdued effect on the regression result. Summary. Today, we introduced the concepts of residual, leverage, and cook's distance. We analyzed the impact of the measured observations on the regression result. We could see that in some cases, the regression result could be largely affected by a few influential points. So, we should be very cautious. Please visit our Facebook page for more information and videos. Also, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can find the Prima Excel installer at our GitHub repository. Thank you so much. Until next time, bye.